Once the Hajj season is over and the month of Dhul-Hijjah comes to an end, Muslims mark the end of the Islamic year. And on the 1st of Muharram, the new year begins.
But Dad, the new year is not for a long time. What do you mean it's the new year?
No, Ahmed, I'm talking about the Hijri year. Muslims use the Hijri calendar, and we've done so for over 1400 years. It's a special calendar that begins in the year of the Hijrah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
The Hijrah? What's the Hijrah?
The Hijrah is one of the most significant moments in the history of Islam. It's the migration of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Mecca to Medina. Prior to the migration, the Muslims in Mecca faced severe persecution for following the religion of Islam. They were boycotted, abused, and outcast to the outskirts of Mecca for their beliefs, and were forced to live life in the most horrible conditions for years on end. Being unable to bear the torture, Muslims were in dire need of a safe haven and a place where they could freely practice their faith in peace and security. This distant hope was, however, to soon become a reality after groups of people in the city of Yathrib, or what we now know as Medina, began to embrace Islam. The Muslims of Medina soon visited the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and promised him security and safety for the Muslims were they to migrate. They gave their allegiance to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and thus the believers of Mecca began to make the journey. Within 2 months, almost all of the Muslims of Mecca had migrated. However, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself stayed behind, awaiting the specific permission of Allah to leave. Once he received permission, he rushed to the house of Abu Bakr in the noon and advised him it was time to make the journey. Abu Bakr pleaded if he could accompany the messenger, to which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied yes. Abu Bakr burst into tears of joy, knowing he was to accompany the messenger on one of the most important journeys of his life. That evening, a group of leaders of the Quraysh met up to devise a plan to bring a halt to the mission of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They had realized the Muslims were gaining traction in Medina and devised a plan to end Islam once and for all. And as per the suggestion of Abu Jahl, they agreed to assassinate the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They elected a representative from each tribe to storm the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and assassinate him collectively. That way, no one individual could be held accountable. It was at this moment Angel Jibreel descended and informed the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to leave immediately. He rushed to the house of Abu Bakr, and the two of them quickly set out on two camels that Abu Bakr had previously prepared. Prior to leaving, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam instructed Ali, his cousin, to return all the goods he had been entrusted with to the people of Mecca. And when the assassins break into the house of the messenger, they were shocked to see Ali instead. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam began to make his way out of Mecca, he turned towards the city and bid farewell, saying, "I swear by Allah, you are the best of lands of Allah, and you are the most beloved land to Allah. And had your people not forced me out, I would have never left you, and I would have never resided in any other city but you." He then continued with Abu Bakr towards the mountain of Thawr. It was there where they were to hide out for 3 nights. Upon realizing the Prophet's escape, the leaders of the Quraysh set out to find him. They put a bounty of 100 camels on the Prophet and searched for him eagerly. And through the help of an expert desert tracker, they were able to trace the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam all the way to the base of the mountain of Thawr. Abu Bakr could see Abu Jahl and those with him through the crevice of the cave. Were they to look down, they would be able to see him too. He was overtaken by grief, fearing for the life of his beloved messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam quickly turned to Abu Bakr and reassured him not to be saddened, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was with them. Of course, the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala soon ensued, and after realizing an intact spider's web enclosing the cave's entrance, the search was thwarted and called off. The following Monday morning, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Abu Bakr set out and made their way to Medina with the help of a professional guide, taking an unorthodox route. After a journey of 1 week, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam arrived in Quba, a city on the borders of Medina. It was there where he built the first mosque in Islam and rested for 4 days. And on the Friday of that week, on the 12th of Rabi'ul Awwal in the 14th year of his prophethood, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam finally entered the city of Medina. The Ansar and the Muhajireen flooded the streets as they rushed out to welcome the messenger. Hundreds, if not thousands, of men, women, and children beaming with joy and happiness as they embraced the Prophet ﷺ. His hijrah was finally complete, and after years of persecution in Mecca, Medina was now declared the new home of the Muslims. He soon built his sacred mosque in Medina and declared the city a sacred precinct. He called upon Allah, "O Allah, make us love Medina as much as we love Mecca, or even more. O Allah, bestow on Medina twice the blessings you bestowed on Mecca." The Hijra signaled the dawn of a new era in Islam, a new beginning, and the foundations of the new Islamic civilization. It's one of the most important key events in the history of Islam, and one which Muslims around the world commemorate every year as we enter the new Hijri year.
If you really enjoyed this video, please support us by clicking on the links below. Give us a small contribution, it will go a long way, inshallah. Visit our website, www.onepathnetwork.com. Jazakallahu khairan.